43% of people with albinism have been shunned from a health facility. This is absurd.
Olive Namtebi, the executive director of Albinism Umbrella, says many people in the country are ignorant about the rights of people living with albinism. Children living with albinism have also dropped out of school due to bullying and discrimination.
Where a child with albinism goes to school and their classmates would want to pinch, others to cut, is your blood red? And the teachers are ignorant of this. They are not giving reasonable accommodation and our children drop out of school.
All of the people with albinism have been shunned from healthcare facilities. This is a very big concern. And we are going to work with UN Human Rights.
Namtebi says sensitization of the public will help keep people living with this condition safe from problems like sacrifice.
They got sensitized that this is a normal child. Treat them well. Love them well. Talk to the father that please don't take away your wife because of this child. It is normal to have albinism.
Parents neglecting their children with albinism is another challenge. When Kusemera Happy, a resident of Chugoyela in Kabare District, had his second child who turned out to have albinism, his wife abandoned them and got married to another man. Happy now takes care of the child with his new wife. Agnes Nampela, the principal rehabilitation officer in the Ministry of Gender, Labour and Social Development, said government is doing all it can to have the rights of people living with albinos protected by coming up with a number of regulations.
Currently, we are drafting the regulations to operationalize that act. In there, a number of issues concerning the rights of persons with albinism have been specifically singled out and have been stated.
Kabalole District has 200 people living with albinism. Dr. Richard Mugahi, the Assistant Commissioner of Health Services at the Ministry of Health, says they are looking at a possibility of fist testing couples before getting married as it is done in sickle cells so that cases of recessive albinos can be avoided. Dr. Mugahi says this will also reduce the numbers of people living with the condition in the country.
We have not introduced that yet. We are doing it for sickle cell. So meaning that in the future, they are not very far. That science will come here so you are able, so that we reduce on the population, on the number.
Story by Jonan Tusingwile for the news.